Hi everyone. In the last lesson, we talked about chaining constructors to give ourselves more options for creating instances of our classes. While chaining constructors helped us in some ways, it introduced a problem where we needed a specific order to create our instance. So in this lesson, I wanted to show you another technique for creating instances in Java using the builder pattern. We'll also discuss a bit about what patterns are and some good techniques for designing your class builders. That's all coming up next. First, what are design patterns? Well, we'll cover design patterns in depth later in another series, but for now, the quick 60-second version is patterns are a standard way for addressing common programming problems with an identified solution. The solution is based on the experience of other programmers before us, and it's usually recognized as a good solution to a known common problem.
The beauty is, when we say builder pattern, everyone should know we're talking about a specific solution, and they should already have a good idea how it works. Patterns are a common language we use to communicate with other programmers. This makes it easier to talk to others about how a section of our code works. So, what does the builder pattern do? The builder pattern is a pattern that allows us to separate the construction of a more complex class from the representation of the class. Basically, that means we're creating a class whose sole purpose in life is to create a class that we want. Imagine we're asking someone to make a PC for us. We would tell them the amount of RAM to use, the hard drive size, the CPU speed, and so on. The person building our computer would take our list of specifications and turn that into a computer to hand back to us. The builder would also tell us when we've asked for something that can't be built, like if we specify a SCSI hard drive and a SATA controller. That's how it would work in real life. Here's how it works in software. We create a class that contains all the state variables we need to set to create a functioning object. We have a setter for each of these values. You'll notice we drop the set word from the method name. This is a departure from how we normally do getters and setters. It's because the builder uses the Fluent Interface idiom. The Fluent Interface idiom just makes code more readable when you're using the class. The interesting part is the setter returns a building object holding the value and any other previously set values. This allows us to chain our calls together. When we're done, we'll call the build method on the builder. That returns us an instance of the object we want, with everything configured. If the builder can't build our instance, it should error out and not return the instance. In Java, the standard way of doing this is to throw an exception. For now, we'll throw exceptions using this code. The illegal state exception is the exception we throw when someone's trying to create a class in an illegal state. Exceptions are a longer topic, again, we're going to cover later. Just know that this is causing an error and prevents the instance from creating. So, how does this all help? Well, for starters, order is no longer important. We can specify attributes in any order. In our football game, we can specify the home team, then the away team, then the starting position, and then the weather. Or we can specify them in another order. In the end, our builder will give us a usable instance or an error.
We'd use this over chaining constructors because we can mix around the order of our state. It also allows us to prevent object creation in an inconsistent state. We can't create a game instance where only one team is specified, or we can't forget to position the ball on the 35-yard line. The builder will not return an instance until it has all the information needed to create an instance in a usable state. The builder pattern, however, would be overkill if you only had a few attributes to set. For example, we could probably not use the builder pattern to create an object with just three attributes. Chaining is a simpler solution for simple classes. The builder pattern is really for larger, more complex class construction.
Let's create a builder for our football game. We'll create the builder class with all the parameters we need for the game class. If we want to give any of these attributes default values, we'll do it in the builder. Each setter sets the value, then returns the game builder instance. Then we provide a builder method. This method first checks we have all the information we need to build the instance. If we cannot create the instance in a usable state, we'll throw an illegal state exception. Finally, we'll need a single constructor for our class that accepts the builder as a parameter. This makes sure the users of our class use the builder one way or another. You can create an instance of your class with this code. This calls the build method on the builder. This is the preferred way to use the builder pattern. Another way to do it is to populate a builder, then pass that to the class. This is less desirable because it's slightly harder to read. The only reason why you can do it this way is because we need to create a single constructor for our game object. This enforces object creation through the builder. The constructor with the builder argument should be the only way to create your instances. This prevents sneaky developers from trying to create instances without using the builder. What we really want is anyone using our class is going to use the builder. In order to completely prevent instance creation without using the builder, we need to make the builder part of the class. We can define a class inside the class, so our builder would be a set of class inside the class. In this case, you'd make the constructor private. This way, we can only create new instances from the builder. There's no constructor exposed.
All right, thank you for watching. That was a longer lesson, so if you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Now, new lessons come out every week, so make sure you subscribe. You don't want to miss a video. And with that, I'll see you in the next tutorial.